Remember when we thought Ultimate wasn't gonna have many combos? Yeah, wrong call from the Smash community on that one. Although it doesn't quite match Melee, every character in Ultimate has true combos, and many have devastating combos that can rack up insane amounts of damage and even not let you play the game. So with so many characters overloading the combo meter, who really has the best combos in Ultimate? We're gonna find that out in just a moment, but before we do, make sure you check out ProGuides.com. On our website, you can dig deeper into Smash with character guides, tier lists, and resources such as our Play with Pros feature that connects you with coaches to help you improve. We've also got exclusive pro courses with world-class players such as MK Leo, Zero, and E-Sam. Now looking at combos in Smash Ultimate, we've selected the 10 characters who we think have the most notable combo games, and we're gonna compare them right now. It seems fitting to start with Mario, the quintessential Smash character and mascot of Nintendo, and maybe even gaming itself. In Smash Ultimate, Mario's moveset allows for him to link multiple aerials together in a myriad of situations. At low percent, Mario can grab any character and combo his up throw into a down air, followed by his up B for some quick early percent damage. Once the opponent gets around mid-percent ranges, Mario can take it even further, comboing down throw into multiple up airs and finishing with an up B. On platform stages, this can even let him true combo opponents into the blast zone for crazy early KOs. You know, if the 50-70 damage he built up wasn't enough as it is. Mario's combos aren't limited to up air ladders. He can combo into or out of literally any of his aerials, and even his down and up tilts too. Getting the right setup near ledge also gives Mario a few routes to combo into his forward air spike to close out stocks off the bottom blast zone rather than the top. Combos clearly run in the family as Mario's twin brother Luigi, well, you didn't know they were twins, has some crazy conversions as well. Luigi's down throw is among the best combo throws in the game, linking into a variety of aerials and special moves at nearly any percent. Most infamously, you know where this is going, Luigi has a zero to death combo off of down throw that works on a good majority of the cast, and still does a huge amount of damage to characters too heavy to be KO'd. Even if he can't get his hands on you at low percent, Luigi can convert into KOs at both mid and high percent, comboing either nair or down throw into up B or tornado to send opponents flying through the top blast zone. I don't think Wario has any genetic relation to the Mario Brothers. Perhaps maybe a distant cousin multiple times removed or something, I mean I don't know. But he does share their affinity for combos. Wario's neutral air can rack up tons of damage at early percent by converting into multiple up airs. Up airs can also start combos when he lands with them. The standout strength of Wario's combos is that he has multiple ways to confirm into his deadly waft to take stocks at very low percents. Falling up air, up tilt, down air, and nair can all set up for waft in the right situation, and since many of these moves also link into each other, a basic early percent combo can often be finished with a waft. Perhaps from training with her friend Mario, Princess Peach has an insane combo game herself. Peach's ability to float just above the ground lets her use her aerials as though they were grounded moves, removing any wasted time from rising or falling with the jump. Both Peach's down tilt and neutral air can start crazy early percent combos, sometimes taking opponents from 0 to all the way to 70 or 80 off of one hit. She can also get consistent combos off of down throw to deal more percent and get stage control. At higher percents, Peach can still convert off of down tilt, sometimes confirming KOs into up air, and her down air can also combo into fair to take stocks off stage. Naturally, Daisy can do all of this as well. We didn't forget about you, Daisy, don't you worry. The princesses aren't the only lovely ladies with fantastic combos, as goddess Palutena is proficient at linking her moves together as well. Perhaps the most infamous combo in competitive Smash is Palutena's nair into Palutena's nair into, okay, you guessed it, you know, Palutena's nair into Palutena's nair, yeah. Palutena's nair is an amazing combo tool, comboing into itself multiple times with the potential to also convert into up airs or other aerials. Her forward air can set up for smaller combos involving dash attack, grab, and explosive flame, which can also sometimes be followed up with an auto reticle. She can also combo out of down throw at many percents, resulting in back air KO confirms at high percents. Quite the opposite of a goddess, the Umber Witch Bayonetta has a wicked combo game herself. Although her combos are, thankfully, toned down compared to her Smash 4 iteration, Bayonetta is still a character designed from the ground up for combos. Her special moves Afterburner Kick and Witch Twist naturally link into one another in various ways, and combined with her triple jump technique, Bayonetta can carry opponents into the sky or off stage, dealing tons of damage in the process. She can link into these special moves with a variety of options such as up tilt, down tilt, and up air. Her witch time counter also allows her to combo into a powerful smash attack to close out stocks. Bayonetta's combos were the bane of Smash 4 players, and trust me, I was one of those people. I got destroyed at EVO with a Smash 4 Bayonetta. But this next character, or characters, wasn't even in Smash 4. That's right, we're talking about the Ice Climbers. In Melee and Brawl, Ice Climbers could combo you from nearly any percent into a KO off of just one grab. Seriously, it was ridiculous! Smash Ultimate's mechanics fortunately make Ice Climbers combos much more creative and interesting, but still deadly. Desyncing the climbers' actions lets players link moves from one climber to the other, resulting in some of the most technical and entertaining combos in the game that rack up tons of damage and can potentially lead to KOs as well. Another retro character who even predates the Ice Climbers, Mr. Game & Watch is a combo machine himself. Game & Watch can easily take opponents from 0 to over 40% off of one neutral air or grab. He can extend these combos even further with platforms. And his amazing up B out of shield can also grant him follow-ups. Game & Watch can get KO confirms from his down smash, leading to early stocks from a charged forward smash. If RNG smiles upon him, Game & Watch can even combo into his Judge 9 to KO opponents at super low percents. Oh, and if his bucket is filled, down throw can combo into Oil Panic at many percents as well. Is there really a way to seg from Game & Watch into Pikachu? Anybody? Alright, well they have both strong combos, that's for sure. Pikachu can loop many characters with his down throw and up tilt into falling nairs to build up damage as well as opponents' frustration. His aerial kit also links together nicely in general, with back airs, up airs, and fairs, all having decent combo potential. At high percents, Pikachu can combo a falling nair into down or up smash for a KO confirm, and he can take stocks with up throw into thunder as well. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the words jab jab? Well, if it isn't power dog, then you've probably never witnessed Terry. Due to his special cancels, the fourth Fighter's Pass character can get consistent combos off of most of his normals, leading into his powerful command input special moves, usually power dog. If Terry is over 100%, he can combo into his super specials Burst of Roof and Power Gazer, which can KO early and also deal insane amounts of damage. Because of the potential for special cancels, almost any hit Terry gets will turn into a combo, making him a great character to finish off this list. So looking at all these combo masters, who stands out the most? We're going with Ice Climbers. Even without their notorious desyncs, the dynamic duo can pull off basic aerial strings like many of the other characters we considered, but with their desyncs, the depth of their combos is nearly limitless. Even ignoring the blatant flashiness of their Twitter combos, these setups have been proven to be practical in tournaments and guarantee huge amounts of damage if not straight up taking the stock. Desync combos aren't just a low percent damage racker, but give the climbers KO confirms wherein one climber can grab and hold an opponent while the other swings a smash attack. Desync combos can also be started with so many different moves, including grabs, so they don't need to fish for one specific setup. All these factors make Ice Climbers our pick for the best combo character in Smash Ultimate. Who do you think has the best combos in Smash Ultimate? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to ProGuides and turn on notifications so you don't miss a thing.